Hello friends, it's Techman Pat here. Hope you are doing well. I know I say that all the time, but I don't know. I think it's all right. I hope you are doing well. It's a good day. And you're watching my video. This is a review of the Wireless Go system from Rode. I wanted to do a quick review because technically speaking, there's not too much to talk about, but it's important to get it out there because I'm really impressed with this product. However, I wasn't very impressed with the support, so we'll talk about that. I'm going to tell you the positives, the negatives, and what you can do with this Wireless Go system from Rode. Now, what is it? You might just be enjoying these videos from me and you wonder actually what this is. Well, it's this here that you've been hearing for the past couple of months. I've been able to review it, use it, and it's stuck with me. I'm going to continue using it from now on. This is an ultra compact microphone PA system. Imagine that. It's got a little box like that, connected to the camera, and this one's just in my pocket right here, and I can talk, connect it to a microphone, and it will continue transmitting that audio to that wirelessly and saving it straight onto the video. Now, the good thing about that is because then you don't have to record the video and audio separately, meaning that editing time will be reduced. You don't have to match up my mouth to the audio, and so it makes life a lot easier. It has a built-in microphone at the top with little attachments to make them fluffy, and you can use them in the wind. So you could just take this, attach it to somebody's, shirt right here, even though it's a big sort of box type thing, and use it that way. It's really nice and quick. So it's really useful for maybe people who are going out in the field to record some interviews, really quick and easy. And the battery on these lasts a really long time. Now, the cool thing about it is that this charges via USB-C. Yes, my friends, USB-C on these little devices. It's very, very impressive. And what's the audio quality like? Well, you be the judge. This audio has not been edited at all. I haven't improved it. I actually never have to because of the quality. However, there are some issues that I faced. So all the stuff I have here are from Rode, but I also had to get a couple of adapters. Now, this is a $200 item, $250 somewhere, and even $280 I've seen at places. So you have to get another $15 adapter to make this work with another Rode product, which is a bit frustrating. Kind of feels like Apple, right? There's a lot of adapters to change it from a three prong to a two prong and prongs that the camera accepts. The next issue I had is when I took off the peel from this one right here, the actual screen came out, the little plastic thing, and I was able to see inside. Now that was a little bit confusing. I was hoping it's not broken. It has been working fine for the whole time. But it's something to note that you never know what could happen, and some of this stuff might not be glued very well. It might be hot when it gets transported. I mean, we're in Australia after all. So when I saw this, I was a bit concerned, but it seems to be working quite fine. It's really easy to connect. You turn on the two buttons and it connects automatically. It's on a 2.4 gigahertz sensor and records at 48,000 kilohertz. So you can add it to videos and it should match up your bit rate and your frame rate quite easily. Now, there is a couple of concerns you have to think about this. Because this is on the 2.4 gigahertz channel, it can be interfered with Wi-Fi or microwaves or anything else. And this is the first problem I faced. When I put this next to my camera, right next to the real big unit of the camera, I was getting a very high-pitched noise. At a certain level, I was able to delete it and post, but it was there. And I couldn't figure out how that was happening. And I spent hours and hours trying to figure out it myself with camera settings, with other things. I just couldn't figure it out.
I am now using the built-in microphone of the Rode microphone system, the Rode Go. Now, here is the problem that I've been facing. I'm going to put this into view here. This is the receiver. The receiver receives my voice, as you can see. Now, hopefully you can hear this as it happens. I'm going to bring this item closer to the camera and I'm going to place it on top. Now, the problem with this is that once this becomes closer, it starts capturing that noise and the Wi-Fi from the camera, or at least something from the camera, and creates a lot of issues.
So I tried to contact Rode support to no avail. I tweeted at them, I sent an email, I even tried calling. Nothing. I'm sorry, I'm a customer. I'm having a bit of trouble. A little bit of help would be helpful. But no, so I spent many more hours trying to figure it out. So you heard it here first, maybe you didn't, I don't know. If you have a camera with Wi-Fi capabilities or Bluetooth capabilities, this little box that's connected to the camera needs to be at least half a meter away from the unit itself. So I've got mine tied to a leg down the bottom with an extension cable into the camera, because you're gonna get some really annoying noises in there and you won't be able to delete it without messing around with the audio file in Audition or whatever software you use. It was an absolute pain to figure out. It was ridiculous. This is not something mentioned on the box. Do not keep it close to Wi-Fi or interference. How are people supposed to figure that out? Do you know what I did? I sat there with the camera, I recorded 10 seconds at certain distances of the box away from the camera with an extension, and all of a sudden I figured out what the problem is. It's ridiculous that I had to do that. I was not happy at all. I was ready just to send it back and go, I don't care. I'll just wire myself directly to the camera as I've been doing for the last 2 years. Once I figured that out, it's okay. The best thing about this is I can get up, I can walk back around, change something on the camera, change some of the lights, and not have to worry about wires or pulling or doing anything like that. And the audio gets saved straight onto the video camera. Now, professional use is gonna be a lot different. You might even have an external recorder this is connected to anyway. So in saying that, this is for your amateur. This is for your person who's just out in the field, doing it for the first time, and they wanted that ease of use. It's there. It works really, really well once you work out the kinks. Now, some of the other things that I noticed about this is that the battery indicator isn't quite correct at all. You charge it to full, then it goes down to half in 10 minutes and stays there for days. The box says it's got 7 hours battery, which sounds about right, because I only use it about 10, 15, 20 minutes when recording a video, maybe a couple of times a week. So it lasts quite a long time. I'm really happy with the fact that it's USB-C, because it's such a small device. They didn't have to do that, but they did in fact do it. At $250, it is actually the cheapest wireless microphone system you can get for a camera. Everything else is $300+, and it performs exactly the same. It's so good, it's perfect. However, there is very little controls you can have on this. The only audio controls is a high gain, medium, and low to control if I speak, a shout, if it's gonna peak. That is the only control you have on the device itself. Obviously, if you spend more on a more expensive device, you'll have very fine control of the gain. Unfortunately with this, you don't. So again, it's an amateur device, but it is a very quick and easy setup. It's very easy to use, and to be honest, fairly affordable when you compare it to other items out there. Now, I'm no expert in audio, and unfortunately, I still don't feel like an expert, because I even did a good degree in audio. I mixed bands, I recorded bands, I know a lot about microphones, but I can't sit there and tell you that this is one of the best microphones, because I just don't have an ear for it. It sounds really good, really crisp, editing is a breeze, I don't have any noises after obviously changing that, and it works a treat. I'm not gonna say that, ooh, it doesn't pick up the highest levels of a person singing. No, probably not. But if you put this on an interviewee, or you put it next to somebody singing, it will pick up their voice really, really well. And in the wind, when you have the little windsock on it, it works so well. I'm so impressed. And it comes with two windsocks, by the way. But it works really, really well. And the internal microphone on this box is very, very impressive too. So, friends, thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed this. Links below to the Amazon where you can buy it, not to the Amazon, at the Amazon store. And if you wanna let me know what you think, if you have one, I'd love to hear your experience with any sort of noise floor stuff, or if you had other trouble, like the screen coming off, little cover here. Thanks for watching, and bye.